so many heavy things, or nose, one other thing. We look, we will get scared. But still, there is some man, for him, that woman is misfit. And it is there, actually it's true. And similarly, there are some men, who look, my God, who will marry this person? But he still, he has a wife and she is quite happy with him. And we wonder why? Because that is the power of Cupid. Or we say the power of, just personify Cupid, Kamadeva. Now, Krishna is so handsome that Cupid runs away. Therefore, Krishna is called Madana Mohana. And Radharani is called Madana Mohana Mohini. Krishna is so handsome, so beautiful Krishna is, that Cupid has nothing to do now. But Radharani is so powerful, she can even attract Krishna. Therefore, she is called Madana Mohana Mohini. She is attracted of Krishna, who even enchants Cupid. So therefore, she has a very special place. And she has, in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is discovered 64 qualities which enchants Krishna. So therefore, even in intro devotional quality, the most. Damodara Rati Vardhana Veshe. And she never, and generally what happens in any relationship in this world, Prabhupada used to say, there is a background of something, what is in it for me? You know, this world, it is like milk touched by even a small drop of lemon or something, becomes curd. So it looks like love in this world, but it is not the kind of love Radha Krishna had. Just like so many girls and boys, there was an instance, you know, it went to the let us not take that. No, it will be a big discussion then. In this world, obviously, we see so many relationships. We think Radha Krishna is also like some girlfriend, boyfriend, they are also like that. Some people try to justify. In fact, one Supreme Court judge, he said, living is fine in India because Radha Krishna was something like that only. He does not understand who is Radha Rani. Radha Rani is Adi Lakshmi. She is original Lakshmi. Krishna is Adi Narayana. He is the original Narayana. Narayana is not an original person. Krishna is the original personality. But you know what happens in the spiritual world? Krishna is not just sitting and smiling. He is very smart. Every day activities are going on. So a Brahma is created. Even in the spiritual world, the Radharani is married to some other man. It's a Brahma. And she is in great tension. Okay. And the husband and the mother-in-law are always, she should not meet Krishna. You know, like that. And every day, she makes an arrangement to meet Krishna. Krishna makes an arrangement to meet her. And all the thousands of her friends called gopis and Krishna's friends called gopas are making arrangement to unite both of them. So that brings an adventure every day. There are so-called mother-in-law and so-called husband trying to see they don't meet. But actually, originally she is Lakshmi only and he is Narayana. This is for fun. It's like a playful mood of the Lord. You cannot play, just like the gopas, they play with Krishna. You cannot play with Narayana. Be respectful. And just like in Tirupati, you go, you have to, at a distance, stand like this. Correct? Krishna is a feature of the Lord where you can play with him. The gopas friend is sometimes with Krishna. What kind of god are you? I am stronger than you. And they will defeat him in wrestling. And Krishna will allow to be defeated. You know, that's the sweet form of the Lord. Therefore, you never hear, so many incarnations are there. Have you heard Balila of anyone? Even of Lord Rama, you never heard. You have to keep a distance. Narasimha Balila. Then you have to keep a distance. Lord is there now. Stand at a distance. But Krishna, Mother Yashoda used to take a stick when he used to break too many butter pots. Now I want to punish you. And he used to shake in fear. He allows that. And take care. He allows the devotees to take care of him. He allows devotees to protect him. He allows devotees to scold him. That is only happens in an abode called Goloka. Why? Because these devotees' attachment to Krishna is so intense that Krishna does not rub on them, he is a Lord. He just wants to be loved by them. And he reciprocates their love. This is a unique abode called Goloka. Even in other Vaishnava Sampradayas, they know about Vaikuntha. Goloka is not redeemed. This was a unique contribution of Lord Chaitanya to uphold the unique position of Krishna. Correct? In all India, everybody, they know Krishna is something unique. He is not holding any weapon, only one fruit. And he's playing with his devotees. It's a playful form. So Lakshmi participates in another way, you can say, in the playful mood of the Lord, in this Radhanani form. Alright, they are actually the same personality. So he is saying, Damodar Arati Vardhana Vaishya. Now in this world, when there is a loving relation, there is something in it for me. It's never 100% pure. Therefore we are seeing so many divorces today. Why? Once you have given yourself to another person, how can you divorce him? Correct? That means, people say, just like we were there in some barber shop, we were there, so his worker said, I'll not work here. He scolded him for something. I'll not work here. I'm not happy here. It's very in local language. So same way they today say, you know, they just one day they say, you know, I'm not happy. In India at least it has not happened that bad, but started degrading. You know, and they just walk out of the relationship. No. But in the spiritual relationship, Radharani rather prays. What is the prayer? The last Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Shishta Ashtaka. Ashrishyava Padarshum Punashtuma Adarshanam Marmahatav Karotuva Yatha Tathav Vidhadad Lampato Matu Prana Nata Natu Seva Napara. She says that you kick me or you embrace. Ashrishya, you embrace me. Padarasam Panushtuma, you kick me by your foot. Adarshanam Marmahatam Karotuva, you disappear and break my heart. Krishna can do anything. It's like Yathatata Vidhata Lampato, do what you want. Madhaprana Nata, you are the Lord of my heart. Natu Seva, Napara. Nobody else. So the dedication of Radharani to Krishna is like this. My Lord, you kick me or you embrace me. Or you disappear, never come again. You are my Lord of the heart. In fact, Radharani showed that on earth. She was in Vrindavan. Krishna, when he went to Mathura, then he went to Dwaraka, never came back to Vrindavan. Correct? Whole life she cried for Krishna. And she never scolded Krishna. You are Vishnu, Krishna. She showed the highest love possible. So her love is not something in return. She is loving Krishna for Krishna's pleasure. And Krishna loves Radharani for her pleasure. That is called love. And lust is when I love some other person, but I have some benefit in my mind. And the other person loves me, but he has some benefit in his mind. That is what happens in this world. And I always tell this joke. The boy goes to the girl and says, I love you. The girl looks at him. Because if the boy says, I want to touch you, he'll get a slap. So he doesn't say directly, I love you. The girl looks at him. Handsome boy, I also love you. Basically, both of them are cheating each other. Correct? They want to use each other. That's where in this world, pure love is not available. Where I just want to make other person happy. This is only possible with Krishna. Actually, we are all searching for Krishna. Because whichever relationship you want, either as a son, or as a father, or as a husband, or as a friend, or as a servant, there are different relationships in this world. No, purity is not there. But with Krishna, you will get 100% pure. And more you are ready, more Krishna is ready to reciprocate. Prabhupada says, supply is unlimited. You want Krishna to be your best friend, he's ready. Tomorrow, your relationship will become sweeter. Day after tomorrow, still more sweeter. Because spiritual world, they don't get bored with Krishna. Because relationship is becoming... See, in this world, we are enjoying only relationship. But the relationship with Krishna becomes sweeter day by day. And Prabhupada says, Krishna will never die. Imagine how permanent it is. And you are also eternal in the spiritual. In fact, you will not even feel. Just like we are looking for employment in this world. Imagine to be employed by Krishna. It's an eternal employment. And just don't feel, oh, body changed. You hardly feel it. And you are with Krishna, continuing your devotion service. In the spiritual world also, what you will do? You will all be standing here, Radha Krishna there, and we are having a dance. That's all. Not that we are doing this, something else you want to do. We are not using Krishna consciousness or anything. We just want tomorrow, in front of Radha Krishna, we should do better kirtan. Tomorrow better kirtan, tomorrow better, and one day, actually Radha Krishna are actually dancing in front of you. And you, that's all. It's not the temple is like an embassy. Temple is nothing. Prabhupada said it's like an embassy. It's like gateway to the spiritual world. Spiritual world, Radha Krishna are there. We are not imagining. They're dancing there. Here, we are getting trained to serve. Even the deities are ready to reciprocate, but we are not ready. Deities can dance actually, but we are not ready. We will start exploiting them. Therefore, because we are not, see today, suppose a rich man comes. You see, people queue up to exploit him. Nobody comes to, they all go, one rich man comes to Mangalore. He was telling me, whenever I come, queue of people are there outside my house with a sob story. You know, this is there, and everywhere I give something. So, Krishna also, people use like that only. They go, give me this. They want to exploit him actually, correct? Oh, you are very powerful, give. Actually, they are not devotion. Give me this, go to where. Nobody is bothered. You know, sometimes sadhus also, people come to know his powerful, they go, Ashirvada. Mm-hmm. I told that joke, Prabhupada was in the train once. So one person came and said, Swamiji, please bless me. So Prabhupada said, what blessing do you want? My back is paining now. Prabhupada started laughing. He said, see, look at this. These boys are there, Americans, Russians. They have developed faith in Krishna. Why did you ask a blessing like that? Okay? Today, actually, all of us know we are born in India. We know Krishna is there. But the difference between us and a great Acharya is faith is so strong. For Krishna, so much he worked. So that way, Radharani's love is unimaginable. When she dresses herself, it dresses herself for Krishna's pleasure, not for her pleasure. And when Krishna sees her so nicely dressed, Krishna becomes so pleased. And seeing Krishna smiling, she becomes very happy, because her mission in life is to make Krishna happy. And seeing Krishna more smiling, she becomes more happy. And you know, any person looks more beautiful when he's happy. So seeing Radharani more happy, Krishna smiles more. And seeing Krishna more happy, she becomes more happy. This kind of competition. This world is reverse. If some person is very unhappy, we feel very happy. And this is reverse world. And if suppose you are happy, other person becomes very jealous, envious. He wishes bad for you. This world is a gutter world actually. But in the spiritual world, it's reverse. And there is another kind of competition going on. Explosion goes on, resonance goes on. In that pure world, today we cannot enter, because heart is not free. Therefore, temple is nothing but a training center. I have to do something in my life for my maintenance. That's everybody does. Even every bird or a tiger has to go to get its food. Little effort is there. Ugra karma we should never do. Some effort is always there to fill the belly. Bird gets up in the morning, goes to the top of the tree, some fruits are there. But it has to fly little. Some work. God has made arrangement in this world in such a way that actually little effort everybody can maintain. We have, as humanity, messed up. We have made a mess. Just to make a livelihood, an animal is not having so much anxiety. He also has to, it's a curse in this world, annamaya. Everybody has to work little for its food. Correct? This is the punishment in this world. Soul doesn't need food, body needs food. So this, along with the body, with the package, the deal, one problem is there. This body needs food. The spiritual world soul does not need food. If they eat just for pleasure. But body doesn't need food. In fact, food also is conscious there. When eating there, it's another love of Krishna you are just drinking. Another, just like Kirtan drinking, just drinking another love of Krishna. Because the eating is different from eating here. Nothing is destroyed in eating. It's like Krishna eats food, it remains as it is, no? Into Nevedya. You see, plate is not empty. Because their eating is different. Om Purnamadam. Like that. So anyway, so what happens in the spiritual world is completely different than what happens in the material world. So that's how it's Ananda Budhivardhana. It's a place where pleasure is always expanding. So, but the animals don't struggle too much in this world. They're more intelligent than us. But we look at the anxieties we have. Somebody says, if the Greece now election is going to happen, if that collapses, the whole world economy will shake. Price may reduce in Mangalore of the land because of that. They just imagine. So complicated we are made. What Greece has to do, what we have to do with Greece. But, you know, an animal doesn't happen. In fact, today the world has become very, very complicated. So many anxiety. Vishvamana nadadi navashakhi leke. So there are so many Vrishabhanu, see the daughter of Vrishabhanu, and she is always among the thousands of gopis. She is the leader by her qualities. Lalita Shaki Kuda Ramita Vishake. All, everybody is conscious of her wonderful qualities. Then last prayer, Karuna Kurumai. You captured the heart of Krishna. You are so great, Radharani. Karuna, please have mercy upon me. Karuna Bharite, you are full of compassion. Please be merciful to me. Who are you? Shanaka Sanatana Varnita Charite. You are not just an ordinary woman. Even great acharyas like Shanaka Sanatana, they are worshipping you. You are so great. Great acharyas worship. In fact, Krishna wanted to teach Uddhava. Uddhava was a great devotee of Krishna. Krishna wanted to have a hint who are the gopis. So, how great they are. So, Krishna sent him with a letter to the gopis. Because Krishna never came back, they were always crying in separation from Krishna. Krishna sent a letter to the gopis. In fact, Krishna's love for them is so intense. Krishna, the Supreme Personality, who as Vedavyasa, he wrote down like pearls, his hand was shaking while writing. So handwriting did not come very well. So Uddhava did not directly get the letter because they were not able to read. He said, I will read the letter. So they all sat down to hear the letter of Krishna. So when they were hearing, Uddhava could see the love they have for Krishna. He thought, I am a great devotee. My God, these people are so happy. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself was such a strict sannyasi that no woman could come near him. You know, sannyasi was so strict. He had thousands of women worshipping him, but they could not come near him. He was following strict sannyasi. Still, he said, nobody can compare the love of gopis to Krishna. Ramya Kajudu, Upasana, Vrajavadhu. These girls of Vrindavana, their devotion to Krishna, what they showed, the gopis, it's a topmost way of worshipping Krishna. This worship of Krishna is the greatest. So even great acharyas, they worship the gopis' love of Krishna. It's beyond actually anybody's capacity to even understand. In fact, it is said the gopis' love to Krishna should not be even discussed till our heart is pure from sex desire. Because there is no sex in that love. Shastra says if we hear gopis' love of Krishna from authority, submissively, you become free from sex desire. Because sex desire is nothing. What is sex desire in this world is actually lust only. It is not pure love. Okay? So in this way, it is explained. So it's a beautiful prayer by Rupa Goswami. We should also pray to the gopis, Radhanani particularly. In fact, in Vrindavan, if you go, they say, everybody has gone. Radhe Radhe, Radhe Radhe. They're very intelligent actually. Why? If Radharani accepts somebody, Krishna will immediately give sign, victory. Recommendation of Radharani, Krishna will never refuse. And Radharani is such an exalted devotee. She feels that she is not a devotee at all. That happens in Mahabharata. So that in the same mood, Radharani is feeling, I am not a devotee. And you go to Radharani, and just like we are given a rose, please offer to Krishna. Immediately she will be, oh, such a nice devotee has come and Krishna will accept us. So we should pray daily to Radharani, please accept me, please give me your mercy. Okay. We approach the deities of mercy. Okay. So the Radharani, the topmost merciful personality. Shri Prabhupada ki, Radharani ki, Rupa Goswami ki.